ScotWeek is a nonprofit 501c3 created in Los Angeles, the entertainment capital of the world. ScotWeek's mission is to celebrate and perpetuate the very special relationship between Scotland and the United States, as well as modern Scottish culture combined with traditional Scottish history. ScotWeek was created to shine a spotlight on Scottish contributions not only in the U.S., but throughout the globe, by highlighting Scotland's rich history of art, music, film and television, business and innovation, travel, food, and drink. As a charity, ScotWeek provides educational and internship opportunities through our partnerships with the Scottish Business Network, Entrepreneurial Scotland, and the Saltire Foundation, all with the support of the Scottish Government. In this series, we'll go behind the scenes of entertainment and industry as we interview our favorite members of the Scottish community. Get a first-hand look at the cultural contributions of the Scottish diaspora and travel with us around the world on an exciting journey to experience all things Scottish.
Hi, I'm Cindi McIntosh.
And I'm Kelsey Deanna.
And this is ScotWeek.
Hi everyone, I'm Cindi McIntosh, president at ScotWeek. And all of us here at ScotWeek would just like to wish you and everyone around the world a happy St. Andrew's Day.
Okay, something Scottish. This is something that actually got me the birth certificate when I was at school. I haven't done this poem until today, so hopefully I remember it. It's called This Here Finger. You hurt your finger, dear wee man. You're pinky, deary me. I just you hold it that way till I get my specs and see. Aye, so it is, and there's the scalp. But didn't greet me there. See there now. My needle's gotten it out. I'm sure that was me, sir. Your finger's sore as well. Yeah, rogue, you're only letting on. We'll now see now. There you are. Right up, the same as John. I thank you. Happy St. Andrew's Day.
Everybody, thank you so much for joining us on St. Andrew's Day, and I am so excited to introduce our guest to you. And I know that most of you already know Kyle Dawson, president of NYC Tartan Week, who we've had with us several times. And Kyle, I just want to say thank you again for partnering with us and with ScotWeek for this special day of presentation of all things St. Andrew's this year, 2020, during the
pandemic. Oh, Cindi, you know what? It's always a pleasure to partner with ScotWeek. You guys always do fun stuff.
Yeah, and you're always very fun, and it's a joy to have you on here. And I also wanted to introduce my two other guests, Mr. Michael MacFarlane, and Deanna MacFarlane. Michael MacFarlane is president and head of Clan MacFarlane Society. I hope I said that right, Michael.
Mm-hmm. Yes, you did.
Thank you so much for being on here with us today. And you just are about to have your Clan MacFarlane AGM coming up here on December the 5th. and that's very exciting. Mm-hmm. What can you tell us a little bit about Clan MacFarlane and what you're doing right now?
Well, we're very excited. This is our first virtual annual gathering that we're having this year. And we're very excited about it, so we can gather our clansmen from around the world to participate in this.
That's amazing. It's wonderful that you're doing a virtual and hosting it, your AGM virtually, because I know a lot of people have just canceled. It's so refreshing to hear someone who's not canceling but choosing to find a better way, for lack of better words, of how to hold your AGM. And and your beautiful wife, Deanna McFarlane, who also is all things to ScotWeek. You've seen her face many times and heard her beautiful voice on the ScotWeek channels and seen her work on our website as well as everything that we produce. Deanna McFarlane, welcome.
Hi, everyone. How are you doing? It's so good to join you guys on St. Andrew's Day. We are very excited. Yeah, no, we are extremely excited to be putting on our very first virtual event for Clan MacFarlane. It is the 47th Clan MacFarlane virtual annual general meeting and world gathering. It's being broadcast for our members directly on the our Clan MacFarlane website at macfarlane.org. It's a lot of work. We have a lot of exciting things happen. We're going to be interviewing, we're going to have music. We're going to have interviews with the two of you. We're going to have interviews with Scottish clan chiefs. We're going to have special rare documentaries that talk about the history of Clan MacFarlane. And it's only going to be a small thing. And then we're also going to have our annual general meeting with our clan officers, commissioners, and staff. And it was initially going to be this small thing that we were doing, and now it's grown huge. It's going to be fantastic. And we can, and it's available for the Clan MacFarlane membership. So if we have any MacFarlanes that are watching today, Cindi, and they're not an active member of the International Clan MacFarlane Society, we urge them to go to macfarlane.org and join so that they can be part of the gathering. We can't wait.
Well, and so Michael MacFarlane, I don't know how many SEPs are part of Clan MacFarlane. And for all of those of you who are tuned in today that maybe don't know that much about the Scottish clans, they're the major clans, and then each major clan has SEPs as well, which are other names that actually belong to Clan MacFarlane. Are there a lot of those? Can you tell us some of those names? And so people need to actually research. They may be part of Clan MacFarlane and maybe not know that they are.
Well, there's literally over 100 different associated family names with Clan MacFarlane, as well as many different variations of the name MacFarlane itself. But some of the more popular ones are Knox, Miller, McKinley,
Weir.
Weir is one of the other ones there. At our website, macfarlane.org, we have a list of them all and all the variants of them.
That's fantastic. Yeah. And I encourage everyone to go look at the Clan MacFarlane website. It's beautifully done. Again, Deanna MacFarlane made that website as well.
Oh,
and and check it out. And how long have you been heading up Clan MacFarlane, Michael?
Since 1995. I was elected vice president, and I soon took over as president, and I've been president ever since. And I'm also the chairman of the Clan MacFarlane Charitable Trust in Scotland.
That's amazing, and I was so honored to be able to travel with your clan last year and witness your AGM in person in Scotland in Loch Lomond. It was beautiful. Rained a lot, but it was beautiful nonetheless.
We're planning on going back in 2022. So
I have to take a second to talk about Cindy's resilience. Is on that day it was pouring rain, as it is in Scotland.
Mm-hmm.
She just had a broken. She just had an accident, so you were in a knee brace, and we were on our ancestral island of Ivel at the ancestral castle, which is not an easy piece of landscape to navigate. And you were there, and you played in the rain. And we just want to say to you that you are such a rock star in our eyes, and we love you so much. And we so appreciate you and all the work that you do for the Scottish community and for Clan MacFarlane.
Yes, the boat basically beaches on the beach of the island. And then two of us grabbed Cindi and actually carried her off the boat. And we had to carry her and put her back up on the boat to leave again in the rain. It was great.
I had a shattered kneecap. That was all kinds of fun.
It was one of those things that kept getting worse, and we kept hoping it would get better. And by the end of the day, we looked like a bunch of drowned rats in McFarlane Tartan.
But again, it's that Scott spirit, you know, and Kyle, it's that Scott spirit, man.
It sure is. Yeah,
never die.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, we don't give up, right? We're not going to give up. So talking about not giving up, I wanted to talk a little bit about, you know, because we are still holding out that we're going to be able to hold our ScotWeek events this coming April 2021. And so we're holding out hope that we will be able to. We're going to all, you know, press forward full steam ahead in planning these events. And so Kyle, with NYC Tartan Week, you're planning your events. You're planning your parade. We're doing this.
That's right. We're moving forward. You know, we're moving forward with that, as everything is going to be good, and we are going to be planning it, having the parade, and then getting on a plane and coming out to LA to do ScotWeek in LA. It's going to be a good week and a half worth of fun.
We're going to have the best of times. And so tell us the dates. And what events you're having and what those dates are and how people can find you.
Yeah, no problem. April 10th is going to be the parade. So after April 10th, before April 10th, the 9th is the pre-parade Cayley. The 8th is St. Andrew's Society does a gala that night. The 7th is usually Wednesday, is usually the day that we actually do a kickoff welcoming party for Tartan Week, but I think we're going to move that to the 6th just because it's Tartan Day, and why not have a big party on Tuesday? So everyone's got to come in a day early this year. So, and I don't think we'll have a problem since everybody is fed up with being locked in and they want to come out and enjoy the world again. They'll come out for an extra day, and then we'll be on a plane to come out to you for Wednesday.
I cannot wait. And I'm so grateful that you have that same spirit of, we're going to do this no matter what. So we're going to do it.
We're hoping to do it. Yeah, we are definitely planning and definitely moving forward. It's all a matter of what New York City tells us we're allowed to do.
Sounds amazing. Just want to wish everyone a happy St. Andrew's Day. I hope that you're there in your homes or with just a couple of friends, is whatever your state allows you to do. And enjoying your St. Andrew's Day and having something good to drink and something good to eat and maybe wearing a little tartan if at all possible. Let's just keep up the cheer. Keep everyone going.
Mm-hmm. Definitely.
Yes.
Happy St. Andrew's Day, everyone. Enjoy the rest of the program. We'll see you soon. Bye for now.
Bye for now, and happy St. Andrew's Day, and Slanchava to everyone out there.
Mm-hmm. It's always a mystery to me that people know I'm a Scot. Happy St. Andrew's Day.
Just want to say thank you to everyone here at ScotWeek, and Nuluk Creol, which is Merry Christmas and Happy New Year.
To make her way over the sea to Mull now, as Chef Gary McLean continues his search for the best the island has to offer.
As a chef, ingredients mean everything to me, and there's nothing more exciting than tracking down the very best flavours from their source.
Gary, named by the Scottish Government last week as Scotland's new national chef, is in Tobermory now to uncover the secret of the perfect smoked fish.
When it comes to smoked fish, salmon has long been king. But for the last 40 years, Tobermory has been home to a family business, making a name for themselves smoking salmon's frequently overlooked cousin. Hi, Sally.
Hi, Gary. Hiya. Nice to see you.
Nice to see you.
Welcome.
Come with me.
Sally Swinbank is the third generation of her family.
I always love opening these boxes.
To inherit the secret Tobermory recipe for smoking trout.
Wow, absolutely gorgeous.
So this is rainbow trout.
Why trout?
My grandparents started the company in the 70s. It's always been smoked trout. We've just carried on the recipe.
To untrained eye, it actually just looks like salmon.
I feel it's leaner than salmon, and also I think it's much tastier.
So there is a flavour difference?
Oh, absolutely.
First, it's got to be filleted.
We've got to have a fish.
And Iain Wiltshire is an expert.
As few cuts as possible and make the trimming minimal.
That's impressive.
I would regard that as ready for the next process. Show me how you would do it.
This is the most pressured thing I've done in a while.
This is worse than being on MasterChef.
So what I'm trying to do fundamentally is not make myself look daft.
I don't know what Sally's going to do with him.
Okay, we'll do it. I'll post it up and I'll make his lunch.
Gary, this is Mum, Rosie.
Hi, Gary.
Hi, Rosie, how are you?
Very well.
Sally's mum, Rosie, takes my not-so-expertly prepared trout for the next stage in the process, salting. But there's more to it than just salt.
So in here, what have we got?
We have got...
I'm trying to steal your recipe, yes. Did you see that?
Oh, Sally's shaking her head. No, I can't tell you, Gary,
you can't
I'm
tell
sorry.
Me. It's fundamentally salt, sugar, and then you can add...
Yes. There's one of yours, Gary.
Yes. Get it covered up quick.
I knew I'd never get that one past the boss.
We all love trout.
Yeah.
I mean, salmon has its place in the market, but trout's got a much more delicate flavour. Yeah.
Can I open it?
Yeah, go for
it.
Are
you sure?
Mm-hmm.
This is
and that flavour comes alive in the smoker.
Wow. That smell is unbelievable. And it's really sweet and...
Yeah, we use beechwood chips.
And it takes on such a wonderful colour. That is absolutely stunning, isn't it? Can we taste? That's the most important thing.
You can definitely taste. It probably arrived with us about 72 hours ago. It's been filleted, it's been salted, it was in the smoker, it's been chilled for about 24 hours, now it's ready to go. Good?
That's so good. I just love food that just gives you that involuntary smile the minute you taste it. Can I take this away with us?
I'd love you to.
I have a plan for this fish. It's heading back with me to the City of Glasgow College.
Guys, have a taste.
When I'm going to show my students just how special smoked trout actually is.
Do you taste the difference?
Mm-hmm.
It's completely different, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Texture's different.
Mm-hmm.
I think the first thing I noticed was the colour. Really deep, really rich and vibrant. And I think the flavour actually matches the colour. You know, it gives you a big hit. What we're doing with this today is we're going to make a fantastic winter salad. We've got some manchot, some French beans, and a little mixture of just greens, watercress, pea shoots, a little bit of baby spinach. Got a little bit of dry tam just for a bit of texture and a bit of saltiness because the trout's so sweet. I'm going to fling in some almonds in there. Just again, just to change that texture. Because what you're looking for, particularly with a salad, I think every mouthful needs to be different.
I start off by blanching the vegetables, scalding them in boiling water for a few seconds, then plunging them into ice, and then I start work on a lemon dressing.
So for me, there's nothing more lemony than the zest. Just in there. Just going to add a little bit of olive oil, and it's quite a simple dressing. pop in a little bit of chopped chive. Guys, we're just about there.
Gary, how does the cost change between smoked salmon and smoked trout?
The answer actually surprised me. Trout's cheaper.
Right.
Now it's time to build the dish, and I'm putting it all on a layer of pea puree.
And there's a lot in it, although it's a salad, there is a lot in there, a lot of different flavours, different textures. A fantastic salad for this time of year. I mean, this could even be perfect on Christmas Day.
The addition of some lemon dressing and the plate is ready.
Hey guys, who fancies a taste? Tuck in. There you go, that was a smoked trout and green veg winter salad.
Oh, Shakespeare. Oh, hi. You just caught me reading the bard, William Shakespeare. Third part of King Henry, V1. So that's what I do to unwind. I'm Grant O'Rourke. You might know me from my famous role, Rupert Mackenzie, an Outlander, and other roles. I know that as a part of ScotWeek, there's lots of other interviews being carried out today. So I apologise for this. This isn't the quality content that you become accustomed to. I'm sorry for pre-recording it, but I felt like this was the only way to get my feelings across, uncensored, unfiltered, and unedited, all in one take, just straight off the top of my head. But I'm mostly just recording this to wish you in North America a happy Tartan Day. What is Tartan Day for those of you outside of North America? Well, off the top of my head, Tartan Day is a North American celebration of Scottish heritage on April the 6th, the date on which the Declaration of Arbroath was signed in 1320. It originated in Canada in the mid-1980s. It spread to the other communities of the Scottish diaspora in the 1990s in Australia. The similar International Tartan Day is held on July the 1st, which is not the day, not April 6th, not today. So that's a different day. So to Australians, I'm not wishing you a happy Tartan Day, because that's a different deal. Yeah, I'm celebrating by wearing my tartan pyjamas. These are my evening pyjama trousers, because they're purple, a sensual colour for the night. Normally I like to wear a blue tartan pyjama during the day. Every day is Tartan Day for me. Every day is pyjama day at the moment for all of us. And if we can take any solace from this whole coronavirus thing, maybe it's that. Maybe it's the amount of time we get to spend wearing pyjamas, which for me is a bonus. But obviously everything else that goes along with it is not great. So, chin up with regards to that whole situation. Besides just wearing my tartan PJs, I like to celebrate Tartan Day by being Scottish and living in Scotland and just enjoying that you guys get to enjoy your heritage and appreciate you for that. I like to return the favour to the people of North America for appreciating their Scottish heritage by celebrating American culture and dressing up like a cowboy with a cowboy hat on. That's what I do, eat hot dogs, listen to jazz, read comic books, they're American, watch films are American, yes, okay. That's so I do stuff like that. I do that, a lot of that actually, all the time. You know, like 365 days of the year. So that's me paying that back to you there, North America. I don't know what Canada does. So I'm not as familiar with Canadian culture, but Don't judge me for it. So what have I been doing during this time of isolation and social distancing? Well, I started growing a beard again. This has been like this about 20 minutes of growth. So that should come up nice tomorrow. And I also cut my hair. I mean, I've done other stuff that isn't, it's not all just hair stuff. I do have interests out with hair. Mostly, I've been in the house, spending time with my beloved wife and son, and hiding in places in the house where they sometimes can't find me, in a cupboard or under the bed. And taking the time to just really appreciate and be thankful for what I have, and hiding. What am I looking forward to post-isolation? Well, you know, I didn't realise how much I missed hugging people. I'm a real hugger, so I kind of miss the little reassuring squeezes and pats that you can get in a hug. Obviously, you've all hugged someone. I don't need to explain what a hug is. But yeah, I kind of miss hugging people. And also just going outside for walks. Because I know they tell you can do an hour of exercise a day at the moment. But it's not mandatory, so you can't make me. But I look forward to you know, going outside for work and things like that. That's probably the fresh air, the quiet. Yeah, that's right up there. What am I looking forward to for ScotWeek? Well, obviously, with ScotWeek having been postponed, that was a disappointment, but we all have to, we're all in the same boat right now. And by boat, I mean our houses, we're all in our houses. But the later ScotWeek, which will be later in the year, and which I hope to be able to come along to, what I'm looking forward to is being in LA, which should be fun at that time of year. The red carpet gala sounds nice, because who doesn't love a gala? Well, the cleaners, I imagine, probably don't enjoy it much. They probably got a lot of cleaning up to do afterwards. The people at the hotel or conference centre, whatever it is, that have to put all the chairs away, that'd be a long shift, you know? Oh. But the actual gala, part of the gala itself, that'll be fun. Looking forward to getting dressed up for that. If we're all still wearing fancy clothes by then, who knows, might be like an apocalyptic leather-based culture that we have by that point. And obviously, I'm also very much looking forward to the rehearsed reading of Macbeth. Obviously, as I say, I really hope to be able to make it along to that. It's got an amazing cast, and it'll be fantastic to work with the director and everyone involved. And I actually did a production of Macbeth when I was 19, so it's a play that's lived in here for a long time. I'm very familiar with it. It includes such wonderful passages as, harp on it, still shall I, till heartstrings break. Now, by my George, my garter, that's Richard III. Yep. I mean, I should have looked for the quote first, actually. I shouldn't have just assumed that I would just open the book and, I mean, it's the complete works. There's like 1,000 pages in it. Well, anyway, it's got lots of great lines in it, and I'm looking forward to, you know, the opportunity to read the actual words, and not Richard III. So look, I know it's not easy just now. We're all just getting by day to day, seeing what happens as it unfolds. But look after yourselves, and hopefully, fingers crossed, I'll see you at ScotWeek. Just going to get back to reading Shakespeare again. Just knock that over. Oh, Shakespeare, you delicious bastard.
There's naught but care on every hand, in every year that passes, oh. What signifies the life o' man, and 'twerne for the lasses, oh. Green grow the rashes, oh. Green grow the rashes, oh, the sweetest hours that dare I spend are spent among the lasses, oh. The worldly race may riches chase, and riches still may fly them, oh. And though at last they catch them fast, their hearts can ne'er enjoy them more. Green grow the rushes, oh. Green grow the rushes, oh. The sweetest hours that dare I spend are spent among the lasses, oh. Give me a canny, my arms are put in my dearie, oh. And worldly cares and worldly men, may I get up saltirio, oh. Green grow the rushes, oh. Green grow the rushes, oh. The sweetest hours that dare I spend are spent among the lasses, oh. For you seduce was near at this, you're not but senseless asses, oh. The wisest man the world e'er saw, he dearly loved the lasses, oh. Green grow the rushes, oh. Green grow the rushes, oh. The sweetest hours that dare I spend are spent among the lasses, oh. All nature swears the lovely dears our noblest work she classes, oh. Her prentice hand she tried on man, and then she made the lasses, oh. Green grow the rushes, oh. Green grow the rushes, oh. The sweetest hours that dare I spend are spent among the lasses, oh. Green grow the rushes, oh. Green grow the rushes, oh. The sweetest hours that dare I spent were spent among the lasses, oh.
Hello, my name is John Harbour. I'm a Scottish tourist guide. I'm Blue Badge, which is an accredited qualification from the Scottish Tour Guide Association. I served in the Royal Navy for over 40 years, and on leaving decided to take up tourist guiding. In the Royal Navy, initially I was a warfare officer driving frigates and destroyers. And although in the last 10 years I've worked both in London and Brussels, and in London I was the spokesman for the European Union's anti-piracy force in Somalia, a fascinating job. Travelled all over the world, been around twice, met many people, served with royalty, and had a fantastic career. The thing I love about Scotland is the huge variety. One minute you're in Edinburgh, in the metropolis, and you drive just 1 hour north and you're into the Highlands. You go further north and you've gone from relatively green grassed pastures to bracken and mountains. And it's absolutely wonderful, the contrasts. The rolling hills of the East Coast and the craggy mountains of the West. Then beyond that, of course, jump on a ferry and before you know it, you're in the Islands. Isle of Skye, Mull, Islay. It's just an absolutely marvellous place. What I offer is a bespoke service. I've got a Mercedes Viano, a luxury vehicle that carries up to 7 people and lots of luggage. And effectively, once you contact me, we'll start the dialogue as to what you want to do. Do you want to go around Scotland? Do you want to see the islands? Do you want to see castles? Do you want to see palaces? Do you want to see Outlander? This wonderful palace behind me, actually, was a famous place because of Downton Abbey. So if you want to know about Downton Abbey, we'll come visit this lovely castle at Inverary. So the sort of thing I offer is really bespoke. It's up to what you want to do. Rather than jumping on a coach and going around and being with a lot of other people, it'll be just be you, friends or family, going where we want to go, when we want to go. I look forward to you joining me on my travels around Scotland.
The devil went down to Georgia. The devil went down to Galway.
1, 2, 1, 2, 3, and...
Yes, so I can.
Hi everyone, thank you so much for joining us to celebrate Tartan Day today. We are very excited for ScotWeek and New York Tartan Week, so thank you very much. My name is Kelsey Deanna, I'm one of the directors for ScotWeek, and I'm also an actor and a singer and a musician and a filmmaker. So to celebrate today, I just wanted to sing a song for you, and it's a classic Scottish song, so if you know it, join me, sing it home. This is Loch Lomond. By yon muddy banks and by yon muddy braes, where the sun shines bright on Loch Lomond, where me and my true love would ever meet again, on the body, body banks of Loch Lomond. Oh, you'll take the high road and I'll take the low, and I'll be in Scotland afore ya. But me and my true love won't ever meet again, on the body, body banks of Loch Lomond. 'Twas there that we parted in yon shitty glen, on the steep, steep side up in Lomond, where in the purple hue the highland hills we view, and the moon coming out in the gloaming. Oh, you'll take the high road and I'll take the low, and I'll be in Scotland afore ya. But me and my true love won't ever meet again, on the bonny, bonny banks of Loch Lomond. The wee birdies sing and the wild flowers spring, and in sunshine the waters are sleeping, but the broken hearted can nae second spring again, though the wave for me cease from the grieving. Oh, you'll take the high road and I'll take the low, and I'll be in Scotland afore ya. But me and my true love won't ever meet again, on the bonny, bonny banks of Loch Lomond.
Thank you.
I don't know if I can see the changes that have come over me. These past few days, I've been afraid that I might drift away. And singing a story,
I'm Gary Carr, member of the Board of Trustees of the St. Andrews Society of Los Angeles and founding board member of ScotWeek LA. Let's take a look at some tartans, since that's what this is all about.
This is my very first kilt.
It is made from ancient MacFarlane tartan. I got this in honor of my grandmother, my maternal grandmother, who was a Knox. The Knox did not have a clan. They were not a clan, although some would joke that they are the Presbyterian clan. But they are a sept of the MacFarlane clan. So this was the very first kilt that I bought, and that was in her honor. She had some Stuarts in her family tree. So when I saw this, I knew I had to have another kilt. This particular tartan is Old Stuart, and it happens to be a favorite of our St. Andrews president, Kimberly Bradford. And it's also been said that this was the favorite tartan of Queen Elizabeth, the Queen Mother. My great-great-grandfather was a Jameson. The Jamesons were a sept of Stuart of Bute clan. So last year, I went for it again, and I ordered another kilt made from this tartan. The last one I'll show today and share with you is relatively new in the scheme of things as far as tartans go. This particular tartan is a Maitland for the clan Maitland. Now, the Maitlands were a lowland clan, and they did not have a tartan until 1953. 1953 was the year of Queen Elizabeth's progress through Scotland after her coronation, and this was designed for the standard bearer of the Scottish national flag. They had to have a kilt, so they designed one for the Maitlands, who actually have served for centuries in both Scotland and England. William Maitland was the Secretary of State under Mary, Queen of Scots. So that gives you a little bit about their background and history. Thank you for sharing your day with me, and sláinte mhath to you. Cheers.
Dum-dally doodle-lady dum-dally do right diddly-eye day. She's already got it. I'll be darned. I haven't finished yet. Heidi diddle-lady dum-dally doodle-lady dum-dally do right diddly-eye day. Have you got that? Will you help us out on the chorus? Heidi diddle-lady dum-dally doodle-lady dum-dally do right diddly-eye day. Heidi diddle-lady dum-dally doodle-lady dum-dally do right diddly-eye day. That is genius. All right, I know a bunch of you have got dance steps that you're dying to put to use. So what do you say we use this dance for? And we'll do this song about like this. Heidi, diddle-lady dum daddy, diddle-lady dum daddy, right in the eye. Heidi, diddle-lady dum daddy, diddle-lady dum daddy, right in the eye. Heidi, diddle-lady dum daddy, diddle-lady dum daddy, right in the eye. Heidi, diddle-lady dum daddy, diddle-lady dum daddy, right in the eye. Heidi, diddle-lady dum daddy, diddle-lady dum daddy, right in the eye.
I'm gonna go.
Yay!